Hello students, myself Dr. Jyoti Shegokar. I welcome you all in my YouTube channel which is made for the study of engineering chemistry. Its name is Dr. Jyoti Dhumare Shegokar. Now in the today's topic, our topic of discussion is mechanism of dry corrosion. Before this lecture, we have seen that introductory portion about corrosion. Now after that, there is a mechanism of dry corrosion. We have seen classification of corrosion, in which simply there are two types of corrosion, mainly dry corrosion and wet corrosion. Then in dry corrosion, again there are two types, that is dry corrosion due to oxygen and dry corrosion due to other gases than oxygen. Before that, I just want to tell you one thing, that please like, share and comment my videos, and then and also press the icon of bell, so that whenever I will share video on the YouTube, then you can get it immediately. So for that, like, share, comment and subscribe the channel also. So now just we will move ahead, that is mechanism of dry corrosion. In this mechanism of dry corrosion, simply first of all we will see corrosion, and then we will see how to carry out process. Now corrosion is nothing but process of oxidation. We know that we have studied it under the oxidation, that is in 12th standard we have already studied. Oxidation is nothing but whenever there is a exception of oxygen, means whenever oxygen is added, that is the process of oxidation. Whenever hydrogen is removed, it is called as a process of oxidation. Hydrogen is removed, and with that, whenever there is a losing of electron pair, it is also called as a oxidation. Means electron pair losing or removing there. Electron pair is removed or it is given to the another one. So all these three are the definitions of oxidation. Just the reduction, it is whenever oxygen is removed, it is reduction. Whenever hydrogen is added, it is reduction. And whenever electron pair is accepted, it is the reduction again. So here we have to deal with a particularly oxidation, because corrosion is nothing but process of oxidation. Means whenever the atmospheric oxygen attacks the metal, there is the process of oxidation, which is called as a corrosion. Now we will see mechanism. First of all, this word mechanism is nothing but the whenever different, for example, there is a single reaction. So this single reaction, here there is a A which forms B. So A is formed B by the addition of C. It is the reaction. But when this reaction occurs, it is not occurred in a single step. First of all, A plus C gives D, and then that D gives B. In this way, there may be the path of reaction, and that path of reaction, when we see stepwise, it is called as a mechanism. So like that, we have to see mechanism of dry corrosion. So first of all, we have to consider a metal. So metal, it may be any type of metal, we will write here as a M. So this metal, when undergoes the process of oxidation particularly, we know that oxidation is nothing but removal of hydrogen, addition of oxygen and removal of electron pair. Electron pair donation, losing of electron pair. So whenever the electron pair is lost, what is formed there? M, it was actually electrically neutral, but whenever electrons are withdrawn from that M, it becomes dipositive. We have considered here two electrons. So there is a formation of M dipositive ion, and these two electrons we can write here, and this is the process of oxidation, because we know that oxidation is nothing but losing of electron pair. Now these electrons which are removed into the atmosphere, because it is a type of dry corrosion, and particularly it is a dry corrosion due to oxygen, so it is called as a oxidation process. Now M is considered as a metal, undergoes the process of particularly oxidation to give electrons, and here electrons are produced. Now these electrons are accepted by atmospheric oxygen. Two electrons are accepted by atmospheric oxygen, but this oxygen, as there are two atoms in a single molecule, we have to consider half of O2. So these two electrons plus this single O will give O di negative ion, that is negative ion of oxygen, and this process is called as a reduction, obviously. Now in this way these two reactions are occurred, and at last we will write here a net reaction. Net reaction means total reaction, how it occurs. So first of all, this M, that is metal, means we have to write left hand side, M plus half of O2 plus these two electrons which are there on the left hand side, then this arrow, this M di positive plus two electrons plus O di negative, is it? Now here electrons are there on both sides, so these electrons will get cancelled, and what product we will get? M plus half of O2 will give M di positive plus O di negative, which ultimately gives here MO, which is called as a metal oxide. So it is a pure metal, and here it is a metal oxide. In this way the metal oxide is formed by the dry corrosion, and this total is the mechanism of dry corrosion, which is very important according to exam point of view, which can be asked for 2 to 3 marks. So hope that you understood this mechanism of dry corrosion. Now after this, again we have to see the next topic, which is related to this dry corrosion. Now see here, we will see a small diagrammatic type of representation. Just consider that this is the strip of metal, and means we will write here pure metal, and this pure metal is in contact with atmospheric oxygen, because we are dealing with the oxidation or dry corrosion due to oxygen. So that's why we'll consider here only O2. Now this O2, when attack on this metal, particularly we will consider that this particular portion of metal is exposed with the surrounding or is in contact with the oxygen gas, while these another parts of the metal like this, they are not in contact with oxygen. So what type of product will be formed there? Now see here, this metal strip, whenever it shows its product, which is called as a metal oxide, and those portion which was exposed with the oxygen, here there is a formation of such type of a thin layer of product of corrosion, that is metal oxide, just we have seen. So that is called as a film of oxide film. At first it is very thin, it is a single layer molecules of the metal oxide, which are formed by this metal by the action of surrounding. So here like this, the reaction of corrosion occurs, or simply first reaction occurs. But here this oxide film which is formed, how its nature, on which it depends that how the next process of corrosion will be occurred. Next process of corrosion will be occurred, it totally depends on those layer which is formed on the exposed surface. Now on that basis, that layer is called as a oxide layer. Now what type of oxide layers are there, that we will have to see. So there are mainly 3 types of oxide layers. Number 1, stable layer. Number 2, unstable layer. And number 3 is a volatile layer. Now this stable layer, unstable layer and volatile layer, in this stable layer, it may be porous and non-porous. So in this way there are 4 type of layers, like स्टेबल लेयर, अनस्टेबल लेयर, वोलेटाइल लेयर एंड पोरस और नॉन पोरस लेयर. मीन्स इफ इट इज नॉन पोरस इट कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज सिंपली स्टेबल लेयर, इट इज पोरस इट इज द पोरस विच इज द फोर्थ टाइप ऑफ लेयर. सो यू शुड अंडरस्टूड दिस पर्टिकुलर टाइप्स ऑफ लेयर्स. नाउ वी विल सी ईच वन इन डिटेल. जस्ट कंसिडर दैट हियर देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्टेबल लेयर. सो स्टेबल लेयर इट इज द लेयर फ्रॉम इट्स नेम. That word stable, it indicates that it is having the stability. It is not unstable. So it is a stable means when once it is formed, it will not be reactive. It will remain as such. So whenever the stable layer is formed, it will remain as such. So what happens ultimately? Ultimately, it protects the next portion of the metal. Because when once it forms, it is formed by atmospheric oxygen and metal itself, but it protect in to this metal in such a way that it will not expose the next portion of metal to the surrounding. So in this way it will protect to the metal itself because it will remain as such. Now on that basis, that how should this layer is to protect, there are two types of layers, that is porous layer and non-porous layer. That is, for that there is one important terminology is given, which is called as a piling Bedworth rule. Piling Bedworth rule. So this piling Bedworth rule, it is very important according to exam point of view, which can be asked for 2 marks. Now this piling Bedworth rule, it says that, see here, it is for the stable porous and non-porous layer. It is said that when this layer of oxide, metal oxide is formed, when it is up to the length of metal, means if the length of metal is 10 centimeter width, 10 centimeter width is there. If the width or height of metal, just it is a height of metal if you see in 3D. So that height of metal is 10 centimeter. For an example, those height up to the 5 centimeter means half of this metal, centimeter not meter. So half height of this metal, if totally occupied by the metal oxide, then it is mostly non-porous. Are you getting? When the metal oxide layer is up to the half of the height of metal, it is non-porous and it is protective, because when this half portion is totally occupied by metal oxide, due to such a more size of this oxide of metal, the atmospheric, that is surface tension or atmospheric oxygen, whenever it attacks on that metal, it is due to such a high size, due to half size up to that metal, it will not attack the lower portion of the metal. So this layer must be non-porous. While if the size is less than the half of this metal, it will be porous because of different type of surface tension on this surface of metal. I think you got this point. That whenever a product of corrosion is formed, that layer should be the as great as the metal itself. Means metal, if it is 10 centimeter total, so 5 centimeter layer when once formed, which is a product of corrosion, by the rapid lot, means number of times when process of corrosion occurs, if there is a half portion is totally get occupied by metal oxide, means half metal is totally converted into metal oxide by the process of corrosion, at that time it becomes more protective than the lower size metal oxide layer. Got this point? It is called as a piling Bedworth rule, which is having the most important example of aluminium. When aluminium shows the formation of aluminium oxide, which is more than its size, means half of the size of its width or its particularly height, At that time, it is more protective. While if the size is less, it is not protective, it is porous. And if it is porous, then through that pores, oxygen will attack on the metal and undergoes the process of corrosion. So, this is the stable layer. I think that you understood it properly. Now, next one is the unstable layer. Again, we will have to draw a diagram for unstable layer. Unstable layer. As its name indicates, that it is not having a stability. If it is a metal strip, undergoes process of oxidation, it forms such a metal strip which is having here the thin layer of metal oxide. So it's a pure metal, and here metal oxide, which can be shown that MO. So here this particular portion which is formed is having a thin uniform layer of metal oxide, but as this layer is unstable, it is having such type of gold, silver, platinum is the example. And we have already said that particularly oxidation will not occur on the noble metals. Is it? First sentence of our first lecture was that noble metals which are there, they does not undergo corrosion. So these are the noble metals, and particularly the oxidation process in this metal is not possible. That means what happens whenever this product is formed, this reaction again becomes reversible, and those product which is formed, it get decomposed. That product get decomposed into the first initial state, that is the metal again formed. So this metal oxide will ultimately give the pure metal and oxygen differently. Understood? So this is the particularly unstable type of layer. While in case of stable type of layer, when once that product is formed, it will remain as such, it will protect the next layer. But here in this case, when once that product is formed, and again if we see that there is no product formed, because simultaneously the both reactions are there, that is reaction is reversible. Okay, now after that, third one and important one is volatile layer, which is most dangerous type of oxidation type of corrosion. Volatile layer. Now this volatile layer, it's this word itself indicates that it is having a volatile nature. You know that the naphthalene or particularly the camphor, it shows the sublimation reaction, is it? Because it is having that type of nature. Means when once it will react with atmospheric oxygen, it gets vaporized with the atmosphere. Means like that, in some cases, here there is a metal strip. It is a metal strip of molybdenum. Molybdenum. It is a particular type of metal. When molybdenum undergoes the process of oxidation, particularly here there is a formation of such type of layer of molybdenum oxide. Molybdenum oxide is formed, and as soon as this layer forms, it gets volatilized. It gets evaporated. And here those metal which remains is having somewhat less size, less its height than the initial one in this way. Now again the same reaction is possible number of times. So in this way, if there is a formation of such type of layer, again there is a formation of such type of strip. Means in this way, those layer which is formed, as soon as it forms, it gets volatilizes, and the remaining metal will be again exposed with the surrounding. And if the number of times, if same process occurs, it will show the totally distraction or totally the decay of metal by the lot of times of reaction. So in this way, whenever the oxygen is there in excess, so in this way molybdenum can be totally get evaporated. So this is the volatile type of layer, which is also possible, which is a product of corrosion. In this case, molybdenum dioxide is the example. In case of stable layer, examples are copper, aluminium, Fe, ferrous. These are the those metals which are used in day-to-day life in a more extent. So the type of stable layer can be formed number of times. So in this way we have seen today mechanism of dry corrosion, with that how the dry corrosion which is due to particularly oxygen is possible to form the different type of layers. Thank you very much.